Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Pastor Patrick, your favorite brother from another mother, bringing you a special announcement to put on both my new YouTube channel, which I have a new YouTube channel announced, that I'll be making a Sunday sermon every week that will be embedded in the new website. Now the new website, which I have the link below, but I'm going to tell you what it is. It's churchfirstborn.com, but this time we used a one with a ST, first born. We changed the domain a little bit, brothers and sisters. And we've added site feedback footer. Brother Clark, who we need to pray for Brother Clark and thank him for making the website for us. We couldn't have done it without him. And Brother Clark is a professional in this area. And he's getting us started on the website. And he set it up for us. He's also, his YouTube channel is If the Lord Willing. And now I've liked a few of his videos and sent them out on my feed over time. Maybe you've seen some of them. He does in-depth Bible studies. He drills down into stuff, into deep stuff, like a Sunday school Bible study class. Well, you know, that's the thing about it, brothers and sisters. You know, people say to me every day, someone messaged me and say, you know, there's hardly nobody preaching like you are. And I just wanted to say this, brothers and sisters, that's what it is. I'm preaching. I preach on YouTube most of the time. Sometimes I teach. So most of the time when you go to churches, you know, even in the Greek, they say there, the experts in Greek will tell you that when in Ephesians 4:11, when it says he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers, you know, they always say, oh, the fivefold ministry. When actually they claim in the Greek that even it's the way it's written in the King James, it says pastors and teachers are kind of together. So a pastor teacher is kind of one. So it's really the fourfold. You know, a lot of theologians who are expert in the Greek will tell you. So that's why most of the time what you hear, what they call quote-unquote preaching, is not preaching, it's teaching. Expository preaching, they call it, but it's expository teaching. That's what they teach in all the theological seminaries. That's what I was taught in school. You know, I've been to churches where they told me, oh, you need to, you know, give us your sermon before you, you know, I was a guest preacher and the pastor went on vacation or et cetera, and they're like, oh, a week in advance. They need my sermon so they could post it on the overhead projector or whatever on the PowerPoint. And also, I guess they, the truth be known, they probably want to see what you're going to say to, you know, approve your message. But the truth is I always tell them, look, I took that class and made an A in it, but I don't do expository teaching. I preach by subject, the subject that the Lord gives me, like the blood of Jesus, etc. So that's what the sermons will be. Old school, real preaching, not teaching, but preaching. But there is always a place for teaching, and I've done some teachings, and I'm getting into this because I'm talking about Brother Clark and his teaching, in-depth scriptural teaching, which is really kind of an expository thing, really getting into it. And we need that too. We need to be root and ground the Word. That's why he gave all those different kinds. We need all of the ministries working together. That's another thing, brothers and sisters. Lots of churches are a one-man show. Lots of churches don't let anybody come in and preach. And they, you know, they use this excuse, oh, we're protecting the flock. But there's also the fact that every preacher, like myself, you know, we have our area where God anoints us and uses us. But, you know, we can't, you know, one person can't really have a complete grasp of the whole counsel of God. The Bible says we should preach the whole counsel of God. So that's why we have different people, people that are gifted in evangelism. You know, when they do evangelism, there's an anointing on them and a gifting on them to do it. And then the people get saved much easier because of the anointing on that person. You know, and they're like, my anointing is really in the prophetic, you know, and rhema words from the Word, you know, a now word from the Word and illumination, you know, of the New Testament hidden in the Old Testament and stuff like that. Lots of videos I do. Prophetic stuff, visions and et cetera like that. And there's other people, like Brother Clark, who can really drill down into the surface text and then really go into it and do an in-depth study, you know, behind the meaning of the words and all that. And that's all those different layers of the onion, you know, the onion layers of the Bible that we need to look at. So praise God for that. And there's others too. As God will make a way. Sister Linda Kirby, who does What's Going On newsletter. She will put her newsletter, will be embedded in the website too. It's going to be awesome. And it's really going to be awesome. We're going to have headlines, these news feeds, on there bringing together an aggregate, big word there, $5 word of the day, aggregate news gathering that Brother Clark has set up for us. And it's going to be awesome. It's going to be, that's a whole nother thing. That's going to be awesome. And for me, you know, those headline things is a big driver for me to check a website. I go check like Drudge Report and different websites because I'm looking for those headlines that relate to the end times, you know, that would relate to something to do with the Bible. And so that's what Sister Linda's bringing together. And what Sister Linda does is she breaks it down and she gives a teaching to explain it to people. You know, instead of just reading the article yourself, we're going to have articles themselves. And then there are people that are new Christians, they're not Christians, they don't know anything about it. Sister Linda's going to break it down for them. That's what God has called her to do, to break it down to people that have no idea, you know, about the end times and all that. You know, like for me, I get into this deep stuff, but you can't get into the deep stuff and then still break down this different level. So that's why we all got to work together as one body, brothers and sisters. Now, Sister Karen, and I challenge you to pronounce her last name. When I met with them in South Carolina this last 4th of July time frame, the week of 4th of July, her and her husband were some of the people that I met in South Carolina last year, if you've been watching my videos. And if I remember correctly, I think her husband's not really sure of the exact pronunciation of his last name. But anyway, you'll figure it out. So she's our administrator on the website, on the virtual church, Church Firstborn. The link is below here. And she will be the one. And so that's why Brother Clark has given us this site feedback down at the footer of the site, at the bottom of the site. And then you can give suggestions, things we can add to the website, and any mistakes you find, grammatical, etc., any bugs in the site, that's what we're looking for. And Sister Karen is, she's on top of it. She's a very meticulous person, and I know that all these people that I'm talking about, God sent them to be part of this. It's going to be awesome, brothers and sisters. As I mentioned the other day, we had Brother Terry, who has a gift of healing there. He's from Australia. Awesome. He and I have been talking, you know, privately for a long time now. And you know, he sent me a few of his videos of people he prayed with, testimonies and stuff. He has a powerful gift of healing. So, and we already have had at least one sister, when I mentioned the other day, who's contacted him for prayer. And he's one of our elders. He's on the website. Brother Gary Bear, many of you know him. I've had him on as a guest. Brother Gary Bear will be an elder, and his area really is, even though he can do other things, but I mean, you know, any of these people can do, you know, like I'm just saying myself, you know, I can operate in any area of ministry, but we all have our specialty. So Brother Gary, looking more at dreams, dream interpretation, etc., those kind of a thing. Brother Sid, his area is, people recovering from alcoholism, involved in alcoholism and divorce. And then we have a few more. We have a few more too. I'm waiting on feedback from other people. They're still going to be elders. Now, Sister Linda Kirby's also be an elder, you know, counseling younger women, you know. Sister Linda Kirby is a widow, and, you know, she's not so elderly, but she's a senior citizen. And so she has lots of wisdom. And then there's another sister in Scotland, and we're trying to determine if she's going to do in that same area too. For people in UK, I'm waiting to hear back from her on that here in a minute. Anyway, brothers and sisters, praise God. We'll continue to build the site. We're also going to have live prayer rooms. If you go in a prayer room, pray with somebody like Brother Terry with the gift of healing, you can set up an appointment. It's going to be on there. I don't know if it's on there yet. We're working on it. Maybe it's already on there, a calendar. And then, Brother Terry, as an example, will make himself available to live Skype with somebody or chat with somebody. So we're really going to do something that I don't know if anybody else is doing anything like this. It's going to be awesome. And myself, you know, I've already been in, you know, I'm already Skyping with people, et cetera, here and there, whatever, informally. But this way you can set up an appointment, you know, just like a real, you know, it's a real church. It's a virtual church. But it's real. It's real people, brothers and sisters. And this is what, you know, what we have in this modern age and the falling away of the church. You know, like-minded believers from all over the world can meet. And, you know, that's the awesome thing about the internet. Lots of evil on the internet, pornography and all this kind of stuff. But this is a blessing. So let's rejoice in what we've been given by God, and let's use it and exploit the technology of this world for the kingdom of God. So I ask you guys to pray for the website. Pray for Church Firstborn, virtual church, online church. Pray for it, all the parts of it. And if you have any constructive criticism or additions to the website, I welcome anybody, because we want to make this the most dynamic. I know it's already going to be. It's already. I haven't seen any church website doing all the stuff that we're doing. already, and we're just getting started, brothers and sisters. God is doing this. It's awesome. Because the Lord had given us the idea to do this 2 or 3 years ago. Myself and Brother Sid had talked about this. Yeah, it's been 3 years ago, 2013. But, you know, it's just now God is, it's being birthed right now. It's coming forward and really being birthed as God wills it. That's how God operates, brothers and sisters. You know, he gives us, it looks like Joseph, you know, in the Bible. I'm preaching a little bit. Joseph had a dream that his brothers and his parents would bow down to him. And they said, hey, he's crazy. You know, this dreamer. Here comes that dreamer. You know, his brothers sold him into slavery. They were going to kill him, but then they decided to sell him into slavery. Then he was falsely accused of raping or trying to have to rape his boss's, his owner's wife, thrown into prison. And then later on, he interpreted the dream of Pharaoh and became seated at the right hand of Pharaoh. But he had that dream. It was like 20 years later that it was fulfilled. From the time he was 17 till he was 30, that's the time frame. From the time he was 17 years old until he was 30 before he realized, so that's what, 13 years before he was in that fulfillment of the dream he had. So brothers and sisters, God will give you a vision and a dream of his goal for you. And then that's when we go through that valley, that testing period. You know, this is an example, like the orphanages. I knew about the orphanages in 2006, but it didn't come to tuition, really into fruition, to 2012, but 6 years. This was 3 years. So there's a lesson on there. Hey, I can't help but give a little teaching there, a little preaching. So, you know, it's that waiting period where we doubt. It's that waiting period whether we will persevere and walk by faith and not by sight, that we see it come to pass. Lots of times people give up. They get out of faith. They get all mad and you know, what's God? What's going on? God, show me this, and it's not happening. And then they just, you know, they backslide, etc. People give up. They lose their faith on that thing, you know, and it was that testing period that God had you in. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I better go. I was just supposed to make an announcement, but you know me. I guess that's what they say about all preachers, right? I will just leave you with this, which I never usually tell jokes, but for some reason this joke's been in my mind. You know, why didn't the pirate go see the new movie that came out? Because it was rated R. God bless you guys. I'll talk to you later.